So in all my videos, somewhere at the end, I mention Webull or M1 Finance, or even if I don't mention them, I always tell you guys to start investing. But how do you start investing without losing all your money? Because that is the biggest fear that keeps people from investing. You don't want to lose all your money. Now, you've probably heard about the system where you invest 10% of your income, and in 50 years, you'll become a millionaire. And that method works, but realistically, I don't want to wait 50 years, and I'm sure you don't want to either, because in 50 years, you'll probably or most likely be too old to enjoy any wealth that you have. So in this video, I'm going to be sharing a few tips that can help you to start investing without losing all your money, and this should help you to gain financial independence much sooner. Now, if you're new to the channel, my name is Ian, and I post personal finance related videos here on YouTube every day. So if you like the content, give this video a thumbs up. I'll really appreciate it. And also consider subscribing to the channel and turning on all notifications for this channel. And this way you can get the updates of when I post new videos here. And I'll be posting a new video here every single day on YouTube. Now, I want you to comment down below and let me know how much money do you think you want to have invested? What your goal is? Is it 100K, 500K, 1 million? Comment down below and let me know. So just as with saving money, the why is very important here. Why do you want to invest? If you have no goal or no reason to invest, then you're just going to download maybe Robinhood and maybe put $100 in the app and never use it again. So if you want to invest, first you need to determine why. Is it because you want to invest and benefit from compound interest to save for early retirement? Is it that you want to create passive income from dividends every month? Or maybe some other reason, but that's the first thing that you need to do. Figure out why you want to invest. Now, yesterday we spoke about how to save, and I mentioned that you should determine how much of your income you can consistently save and do that. So if you decided that you could save 10% of your income, then what you need to do is to then subtract a percentage from that and invest it. Now, I know many people don't have a lot of free money after living expenses, so this way is easier and more realistic. So from your monthly or weekly savings, set a portion of that money for investing. Now, that should cover how much money you should be investing, and even if it's not a lot of money or as much as you would like, the habit of consistently investing will do you very good later on when your income goes up and you have more money to invest. So now I'm going to tell you about three investments or types of investments that you can look into. So the first type of investment is in securities, and this will cover stocks, bonds, mutual funds, and ETFs. Now, there are two ways in which you can go about investing in these stocks, bonds, mutual funds, and ETFs, or at least two primary ways. So number one is buying a stock, for example, $100, and then selling it for $200 when the value goes up. Now, if you did that, then you just made $100, so you can buy and sell or trade stocks and make money. The second way to go about this is to purchase stocks and hold them for a long time, and you can get paid dividends from these stocks on a monthly basis while the value of the stocks also appreciate. So again, it depends on why you want to invest here. If you want to benefit from compounding interest and save for retirement or some long-term goal, then holding bonds, stocks, and ETFs over the long term would be the choice. And then if you just wanted to make money in the short term, then you'd look for undervalued stocks and purchase them. And then when the value goes up, you sell and you cash out. Now, the second type of investment or investment that you can get into is asset investments. And this is when you invest in assets such as real estate. So this could be purchasing a house, a duplex, an apartment, a condo, maybe even an RV lot or a trailer park and renting it, and then getting paid every month. And of course, your income will exceed the cost associated with this, so the profits will be your returns on the investment. This one is straightforward, and I think everybody knows the concept of investing in real estate. Now, the third investment type is investing in a business. This can be a startup, your startup maybe, or purchasing an established business, or maybe even just being an angel investor or investing in someone else's business. So back to the main question, how do you do this without losing any money? Well, if you plan everything safe, then you really won't get any rewards, so eventually you need to take on some risk, and investing in anything is risky. However, let's start with the first investment type, securities. So if you invest in stocks or you're thinking about doing it, but you want this to be as safe as possible because you're afraid of losing all your money, then an index fund would be best for you. Now, index funds are like a collection of many stocks. And so if you invest in one, then chances are the value won't go down overnight. But with a single stock in one single company, that company's stock can lose value at any time and have you losing money. Now, index funds come with a cost and fees, and so the next best thing is an ETF. ETFs come in many different forms, and again, you can find them based on what your investment goals are. So let's say you want monthly dividend income. You can pick stocks in a single company and create your own portfolio of dividend stocks, but if one loses value, then you may lose a lot of money, so an ETF will have usually hundreds of stocks in it. This way, you aren't investing in any one stock, but a lot of stocks at the same time. And if one loses value, then it doesn't affect your overall investments as much. Now, I have an entire video on ETFs and actually maybe two or three videos where you can learn everything you need to know about ETFs. So if you haven't seen those videos, be sure to check them out if you are interested in this one. Now, secondly, investing in assets like real estate. So with real estate, the main idea is that you purchase a property, you rent or lease it, you use that money to cover the expenses and you keep the profits and the property also appreciates in value. However, the main problem with real estate investing is that it's harder to get into when compared to the stock market. So, for example, to purchase real estate, you don't have cash, or if you don't have cash, which most people won't, then you'll have to have a down payment of maybe 10 or 20%. And you'll also need to have money set aside for expenses that will come with the property. So if you're trying to purchase $300,000 or a $300,000 investment property, you may need maybe $60,000 just as a down payment. So it's harder to get into, but usually this type of investment is very rewarding over the long term. So if you don't want to lose all your money here, you want to have your down payment and a very, very good emergency fund. So in case you have to spend money on the property, you don't become delinquent on your payments and get foreclosed on. Now, the third one was investing in a business, and this is actually not as hard as you may think. Now, the good thing about a business is that you can invest money and get even 100 times what you invested in a shorter time. So, for example, I sell on eBay. I may spend $1,000 on what other people consider junk computers, but after a few hours and a couple sales, I may be able to sell everything for $3,000 to $4,000, and this only takes a couple days, maybe 2 weeks. Now, if I invest $1,000 in the stock market or anywhere else, the chances of me making $2,000 from that $1,000 in 2 weeks is very slim or next to none. It won't happen. Also, you have the option of purchasing a business. So, for example, let's say you wanted to start a lawn care or landscaping business. You could get a loan and start from scratch, and this may work out for you, but it's going to take you months to get the clientele that you need to have and employees working for you all the time where you can just sit back and make money every week. This would also be more risky because you'll have competition. So instead, you could purchase a fully functional business that already has clients where maybe the owner needs to relocate or they found some more rewarding opportunities that they want to pursue. Now, in this case, you purchase the business, and the only way that you don't make any money here is if you don't keep the quality of work that they were producing before. Now, in this way, even before purchasing the business, you already know how much money you will make because you can review the amount of clients and the amount of income that the business makes monthly. So if you're looking to make money in the short term, I think a business is the best way to go about it. If you're looking into long-term investments, then the stock market and real estate would be good, but the stock market first because it's easier to get into. However, if you want the easiest way to make money from investments and the least risky of them all, I would say it is investing in ETFs because if you buy a business, then there's a possibility that you, the owner, can mess it up and lose clients and lose money. If you go into real estate, you have a lot of money tied up in it initially, and it takes years for you to break even. If you invest in single stocks and one of the companies suffer a loss, then a lot of your money can be lost, even if it's in the short term. So if you want the least risky investment because you're worried about losing all your money, then ETFs are what you should be looking into. So I'm going to be leaving links here to my videos about ETFs 101, the basics of ETFs, and also any other videos I have on ETFs so you can learn more about these. I hope you guys found this video very helpful. It helps you with your investing and saving. And finally, you can invest safely without risking all your money. Also, if you'd like to see more videos like this one, be sure to give this video a thumbs up, as that's the way these videos get recommended to more people here, and I'll really appreciate it. And also, don't forget to check out some of my other videos here on the channel on credit cards, banking apps, savings accounts, more on investments, ways to make money, and much more. Also, don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so, and be sure to turn on all notifications for this channel, as that's the only way you'll be able to get the updates of when I post new videos here. And remember, I'm posting a new video here every single day on YouTube. And remember, check all the links down below in the description. I've left links to free stuff and free cashback offers, so be sure to check those out as well. Now, if you aren't investing as of yet, you need to start right now today. Be sure to check out Webull or M1 Finance, which both I personally use, and I've left links to them down below in the description. With Webull, after signing up, you'll receive 2 free stocks, which can be valid at up to $1,600. And if you like the stocks, you get to keep them because they're free. If you don't, you can sell them and keep the cash. So it's a win-win for you. Now, with M1 Finance, you'll get $10 for free to go towards your investments. Once again, guys, I hope this video was very helpful. All the best with your investments, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.